Now, what you're seeing is a behavioral sequence analysis. It's a sequential representation of shootings over the past 4 years.
And what does it get us?
Well, this kind of dynamic graph is an amazingly good predictor of what I've been calling shooting chains.
Shooting chains.
Shootings that are linked. One to the next, then to the next.
You mean retaliation shootings? We already know about all those.
Well, what I'm saying is that it might be possible to follow these shooting chains back to the original shooter.
Without witnesses and without testimony.
Visualize a tabletop covered with dominoes. The first domino to fall is the start of a shooting chain. Shooting chains can be short, shooting chains can be long. Some shooting chains initiate other branching chains. Now we're looking at these shooting chains after the fact, after all the dominoes have fallen. And reconstructing these chains is going to be difficult, but there is a way. By using hierarchical network graphs in combination with Poisson clumping, we can work our way backwards, back to the original dominoes that started the chain.
Which means we could identify the insiders, gang members most prone to violence.
That's correct.
And if we could...